Hi, my name is Naomi. I'm just here. I'm going to be performing a postpartum abdominal on you so that we can prepare for you to go home later. I'm going to wash my hands. And then I'm just going to put some gloves on, make sure that my room is safe, which it is. And then I'm just going to check your wristband really quickly if that's okay with you. Okay, and that looks good. First, I'm just going to start off by performing some vital signs. So first, I'm just going to take your heart rate. And I would do this for 15 seconds. Okay, and that's a good heart rate of 70. And then I'm just going to be watching you for your respirations. So I'll do that for 30 seconds. Respirations of 14. And also, then I would take her temperature. Her temperature is good. It's 98.6, which is totally normal. I'd also then just take her blood pressure. And her blood pressure is normal. It's 124 over 78. And we just want to make sure that that matches her blood pressure that was in her first trimester. So that all looks good there. Are you in any pain today? And she said that she's just in, her pain level's just a 2, but that's just what she expects to be normal for right now. So that all looks good. Then I'm just going to do a brief skin assessment on you. I'm just going to be checking for color, which your skin is pink, moist, and dry, so that's good. You have good skin turgor, and your capillary refill is good. Less than 3 seconds, which is normal. Okay, so now I'm going to be performing a breast assessment on you, so I'm just going to pull up your gown. Visually, I'm just going to confirm that the nipples are not introverted or flat, they're extroverted. I don't see any signs of nipple trauma from breastfeeding or anything like that. I'm just going to palpate around for consistency and fullness. There's a little bit of colostrum discharge, which is normal. So that all looks good there. You didn't have any tenderness or anything like that? No? Okay. Then I'm just going to be looking at your uterus. I'm just going to palpate for it at your abdomen, which your uterus is at you. It's not deviated to any side and it is firm, so that's good. Then I'm just going to look at your abdomen really quickly. It's slightly rounded, not distended. When was the last time that you had a bowel movement? Okay, so you haven't had one since your delivery, but hasn't been 24 hours yet, so that's normal. Just let us know when you have one. I'm also going to be palpating your bladder. It's not distended at all, and that's good. When was the last time that you used the restroom and urinated? within the last hour, that's good. So everything there looks good. Then while I'm here, if she had a C-section scar, I would look at it. First I'd be looking at her dressing, making sure that it's not, that it's dry, that it is dry, clean and intact, which it is. I would be looking at her incision, making sure that the borders are together, that there's no signs or symptoms of infection, which there's not. I'd also then listen in all four quadrants. So next I'm just going to be looking at her perineal area. Here I'm just going to be looking for any redness, ecchymosis, edema, if there's any discharge, which there is a little bit. And then I'd be looking for if she's had any lacerations or episiotomies during her labor, which she did not, so that's good. And then she also does not have any hemorrhoids, so that is good as well. Then I'd be looking at her lochia. First I'm going to look at the color. It's red rubra, which is normal for right now. She has not bled through her pad in the last hour, so that's good. I'm also gonna be just like smelling to see if there's an odor or anything, which there's not. And I'd be looking to see if there's any clots. And then if they were not, if they were larger than a golf ball size, that would be not good, but she just has small clots, which is good. Okay. I'm just going to cover you up the rest of the way. I'm just going to look at your lower extremities really quickly. So color looks good, temperature is good. I'm not noticing any edema or swelling. There's no edema when I check for it. I'm also just going to be checking your reflexes. That one's good. That one is also good. That's good. That one's good too. And then I'm just going to move your foot back and forth. Let me know if you have any pain in your legs. This is just checking for clonus, which is good. Just gonna cover your back up. How have you been doing, Mom, since you gave birth? You feel well, you're just a little bit tired. Okay, that's good, that's normal, that's all you would expect for right now. She also seems to be doing well with her baby. She's just holding it and stroking its head, talking to it, so that's good. Her partner is also present. He seems to be bonding with the baby good as well, and he's very helpful and supportive, so that's good. So then I'm just going to give you some education on the postpartum warning signs that we'd want you to contact us about if you have. So first I want you to look out for if you have any chest pain, if you have any shortness of breath or trouble breathing, if you have any seizures, if you have any thoughts of harming yourself or your baby, if you are bleeding through that pad, and more, if you do go through more than one pad in 1 hour, if your C-section incision is not healing, if your legs get red or tender or painful, And then if your temperature exceeds 100.4, and if you have a headache, that's not relieved by Tylenol, or if you have any vision changes.
All right, and discharge education, tell me more about my peri care.
Okay, so when you leave the hospital, you're going to want to cleanse it. Every time you go to the bathroom, you might want to put some like cooling things in there for a while. You will have that red discharge, and then it will turn yellow or light brown to clear. And then around 4 to 6 weeks, you will have another episode of spotting, but that's normal. That's just the rest of your little scab in your uterus coming off. But if you do have any like excess swelling or discharge that's not normal with the instructions that we gave you, we want you to contact us and let us know so that we can further investigate that.
Is that what that little bottle store in the bathroom is to help?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. We just want you to fill that up with warm water and then like rinse it off.
Okay. Sounds easy.
Yeah.
Is there anything else you can think of? If I were a C-section, what else would you want to assess?
Oh, I would also assess her fully and make sure that the urine output was at least 30 cc's per hour.
What else?
I assessed her bowel sounds, her her bandage, and I assessed the wound itself.
Yeah, you're good. Yeah, okay. Okay, I think we did well. There's just one thing. Well, so the C-section assessment, I made a prompt, so that's just one point there. The breast exam, not breast, uterine exam, make sure you mention the actual position of the uterus.
Okay.
So if it's not off to the side, you know, causing bladder, then it's called midline.
Okay.
That's actually the appropriate term.
Okay.
Midline.
Okay.
Midline firm after you.
Okay.
That's a great uterine assessment. Okay. So other than that, you did a great job.
Thank you.
So two, let's see. Yes. And you got to do a Kegel pull.